South Dakota's first state park opened in July of 1919, after more than 20 years of planning and preparation. It was named after General George Armstrong Custer, whose 1874 discovery of gold in the Black Hills essentially paved the way for non-native intrusion and settlement. Custer State Park began as the dream of a politically ambitious well driller named Peter Norbeck. He was born in 1870 to Scandinavian immigrants living in a dugout near Vermilion. After completing his education at the University of South Dakota, Norbeck moved to Redfield and established himself as an energetic businessman. His political career would lead him to the governor's office and U.S. Senate. In 1909, he and some friends drove a car from the east side of the state to the Black Hills.
And fell in love with the Black Hills, and he wanted this to be a place where people could come relax and get out and just explore this gorgeous area. And so it began with an idea, and he started working to make that a reality.
But a lot needed to be done. Soon after the U.S. government took the Black Hills from the Lakota, it began selling land to individuals and giving land to the state. The state received two sections of so-called school lands in every township. But management was complicated by the jurisdictional problem of having state school lands embedded in federal lands. Peter Norbeck saw an opportunity.
What they did is, instead of having inholdings of state land and federal land, they offered, hey, we will trade this chunk of state land for this chunk of federal land so we can get solid blocks. And both the feds and both the federal system and the state system were in favor of that. By trading school and public lands with federal lands, he got set aside what would become Custer State Park as a game preserve.